morning, all of you. Myself, Sohel Bhura. I am from Babasaheb Naik College of Engineering, Pusad, which is affiliated to Sant Gaadge Baba, Amravati University. Actually, we are having two branches at our college, which deals actually with your computer programming, computer science and engineering, as well as information technology. We do also have civil, mechanical, and so on. The syllabus that we are having for computer science and IT, in the first semester we have a common syllabus. Actually, we are not dividing the number of classes into computer science 1 and so on. We have actually divided the syllabus into two parts, CS1 and CS2. So in the first semester we are having the CS1. So we have divided it into three units. First unit covers the fundamentals about the computers. We have 8 hours duration, which is reserved for that. In second two, unit two onwards, we cover the C fundamentals. And unit three, the control structures and loopings. These are the books, those are recommended. Actually, this is the syllabus which is prescribed by the university. Okay, we can, actually the 8 hours, we can reduce it or we can increase it as per our convenience, as far as, again, we have divided the classes as per the branches. So we can concentrate on computer students, IT students, as well as electronics people, more for C programming, because these people use computers. CS programming is required for those people.
Point is for
the total syllabus is divided
two parts.
Okay.
Two
okay.
Semester.
And that is how they are called CS1 and CS2. Oh, so to begin with,
CS2. Yeah.
Followed by that,
arrays, pointers, and structures, up to files we used to cover in CS2. Actually, 8 hours per unit is there by the university that has been prescribed.
In fact, earlier we used to have an annual course, like there were two exams and later it was compulsory that it should be conducted in semester pattern. So what they had done, straightway the 6 units were divided along two semesters.
Two parts.
So first 3 units in first semester and later 3 units in next semester. That is how it is conducted.
Three hours per week for theory and for practical we are having again. Actually, university is giving a guidelines for what are the practicals that those should be conducted. Actually, we can increase or we can make any changes as per our convenience. These are some of the guidelines which are given. Again, it has been considered the students are having zero knowledge about the computers. So, considering those, the CS1 syllabus practicals are being set, we are concentrating more on the C programming for computer science and electronic students. Rest all students are concentrated on remaining things. Similarly, we are having practical list for second semester. So there is a guideline given by the university so as to cover all the topics. So for each and every subject, we are having a list which is prescribed by the university. It is not necessary that we have to follow that only, but it should cover those points. That is the main motto behind that. Because actually what happened, if the subject is new, the staff member used to conduct the practicals as per his choice. So they have given some list of practicals. So you have to follow those or we can modify it as per our convenience, but it should cover those points. That is what. These are the infrastructure features that is available at our college. We are having this much laboratories, computer center. We are having latest configuration, OFC cabling throughout the network. IBM Rational Rose Lab we are having. Dual core machines are there with license software, IBM Rational. 15 machine license we are having. AS400 lab we are having with AS400 server, which was purchased back in 1994 or. Multimedia lab we are having, embedded lab with latest embedded kits, software development lab. Again, this year onwards, we have developed, we have started the Cisco Network Lab in collaboration with JNTU, Hyderabad. So, as our syllabus is not permitting us, or the students are not having that much knowledge about all the things, so we used to conduct some extra activities at our campus. IBM Rational Training Program we have conducted, then Cisco Network Academies. Two of our staff members have undergone a training at Cisco, and they are now conducting the classes for the students. The first batch has been completed, the module 1. There are about 30 students are being benefited for that. Again, .NET, Linux certification course, advanced Java course we are providing for the students. Again, last year, some of the project batches, they have make a survey for Wi-Fi and WiMAX to make the campus, as well as the, we have considered our Pusad town, which is a very remote place, to make it as a wireless. So the survey was made by the students. And then again, various, we are motivating the students to implement the various algorithms which are been as considered as a research work as a part of their third year and final year projects. So this is all about our college. The later part will be explained.
Good morning, everyone. I am Prashant Ingole, representing Professor Ram Meghe Institute of Technology and Research, Badnera. This is again under Sant Gadve Baba Amravati University, Amravati. My colleague Sohel explained you about syllabus, number of hours, and scheme, etc. I am going to tell you about the kind of question papers that are given to the student. Even before that, I would like to show you the evaluation pattern. We have a 80-20 division for that 100 marks of the university. University conducts finally a 80-mark exam, for which the 6 units of the subject, this is for a complete semester, like the 50 mark paper of the first semester will be divided according to this. So, theory attendance we give 25% mark, sessional exam, 3 sessional exams are conducted, which are of the quizzes in nature, and that comprise the 20% assessment, and the rest, that is 80% marks, are the university final exam, which is conducted by university. This is the scanned paper, it is not entered, it is scanned directly. So, this is the kind of questions that they generally ask. First semester paper peculiarly has seen over the year that it is having more of theory and very less of programming, but as this again the scanned version of.
Actually, every question is having its optional part, or part is there for every question. That is what the pattern we are having.
As in the earlier discussion, Professor Hatak requested that it will be better if the questions are given. So, some of the private publishers under Amravati University are printing their log of whatever papers. So, even unit wise questions per year are available. I would just like to show some of them. After the first semester and second semester, computer engineering students go for programming methodology as the next subject. So, where rigorous C programming and programming principles are taught. So, these are the papers related to that. I have nearly 6-7 papers of different years, and followed by that in their same semester, object oriented technology is the next subject. So, these are again the university papers of various exams. It is marked here that this S6 stands for summer 2006. and these are the set of questions. So they are unit wise collected questions, so that when a student prepares, he can look at what kind of questions are asked on a particular unit.
You mentioned that they are published by private publishers.
Yeah.
Would there be a issue of IPR violation?
No, because
the questions are actually question paper or questions from the question paper of university, right?
Yeah.
So as long as I say that this is a question of this university in this year,
right,
there is no question of that private publisher's intellectual property being violated.
No, in fact, what happened is all engineering services exam and other books you would find, even JEE books, they would mention that this is a question appeared in summer 2000.
So as long as we accredit that, there should be no issue. That should be the stance that we will take.
It is clear.
Because you see, we are going to put everything in open source. Now, I don't want somebody in Badnera saying that mera dhanda tumne chaupat kar diya because you have put everything on internet.
That will not happen. So there are publishers, they are publishing it in two forms. Some of the publishers are doing the collection of question paper, questions related to a particular unit and printing it as a book. Huh. Others are carrying it as it is, the paper and the whole paper per year.
Just putting it together.
Yeah. So both of the forms, I will be able to share this with this workshop. I will put it.
So can you leave this copy with us?
Yeah, please.
We can make this as a starting point of our effort.
Yes. So let us say this is the semester 1 CS1 paper. Then we do have the object oriented technology subject in third semester. Similarly, these are the code of university. 4SULI stands for semester wise pattern, electronics, industrial engineering and IT. These are the three branches for which this paper is going to be common. And this is paper number 2 of that semester. So computer programming application, this is based on, like, both of these subjects cover the same thing, object oriented technology and computer programming application. They belong to C++ language only, but since they are for different language, their weightage and enthrustment is different. So they are having two different papers. So this is the paper for object oriented technology, and this is computer programming and application for, this is for electronics and telecommunication engineering. This is for computer science and engineering. So I'll leave these papers with the conference. So basically, this particular slide concerned with semester-wise what different programming subjects students is introduced to, like CS1, CS2, then programming methodologies and OOT in third semester, then data structures and so on. This is for same collection for the information technology department. Then evaluation of the practical, minimum 12 practicals based on the syllabus. Semester 1 evaluation is completely internal. Students are not required to face external university level exam for this subject. In fact, all the subjects. And then semester 2, 50% internals are given, internal examination is conducted. So it is again 25% weightage is given to their attendance, 80% attendance is compulsory, and 75% for their term work like performance, showing output, recording it and so on. And 50% external examination where the tasks they have performed throughout the semester, they are given and external examiner assess it and awards the mark. Apart from the regular lab sessions, students are encouraged to do some simple basic projects also at the second year level. I would like to take this opportunity to convey some very important information which make our institute doing some efforts in this area. Like, our institute is the first in Central Asia to have optic fiber cable network throughout the campus in 1996. With the keen interest by our founder president, Professor Ram Meghe, then Education Minister of Maharashtra, he contacted Professor Vijay Bhatkar. In fact, he belonged to same locality, he's from Murtizapur. Yeah, it is just 30 kilometers away from Badnera. So with that relationship, he contacted, and then we got Param computer again in 1996 only. basically students in final year were allowed to use it to do their project, and that is how our campus was for the very first time introduced to Linux like environment at that time. Institute is proud to have successfully run the SIDAC prestigious diploma course, diploma in advanced computing, SIDAC. All the laboratories related to computer are Wi-Fi connected. It encourages to work individually by providing separate PC to every student during practical lab session. And our labs, project labs, are open even after the regular lecture hours. Thank you, sir. Any questions?
So this CDAC program that you run, does it also have a component on computer programming?
It was basically all computer programming.
Yes, because this is nothing but the NCST's version of
program. NCST's version, but CDAC is still running that program.
Yes.
Important thing about that program is they update their syllabus every 6 months.
That is what I was about to say.
Yeah.
That if you compare the CDAC syllabus,
yeah,
which is awards only diploma,
yeah,
and your syllabus,
yeah,
it appears to me that that syllabus might have some greater strengths in some respect.
It should be called as a post-graduation course.
Right.
Because I saw…
In fact, many BE students,
find it
not
difficult.
Only of other branches, but even CS branches, yeah, have seen them doing the CDAC program.
They have
now,
to struggle.
The reason I brought this out is, should we not endeavor, as being part of a university and college system, where we specialize in education, whereas CDAC at best gives training. Now, education should always be at a higher level than training.
Yeah.
So, should we not suggest that the university should upgrade its syllabus or something like that?
I would like to share one experience, sir. I had been a chance to teach one, two subjects there. So, generally a semester-long syllabus takes only 20 days in this particular program. Every day, they would give certain theory, and then student need to struggle throughout the night to complete those assignment. Only part is they do it single or two subjects per 15 days, that is there, but otherwise it's a very heavy syllabus.
The second suggestion I would make is that if you look at the laboratory description that you have,
yeah,
some other labs, for example Dominic's this thing or many other people,
yeah,
I think their labs are far more elaborately defined.
Yeah.
It might perhaps be useful to try and encourage that kind of definition.
In fact, university syllabus itself,
huh,
gives the details.
Yes, but the kind of problems that are mentioned, they appear to be very generically mentioned.
Yeah.
Whereas we would like to have practicals with specific problems and some. So, in general, is it true that people would have anywhere between 3 hours or 4 hours of practical every week? So, we can assume 3 hours?
Lab.
Because we have only 2 hours here.
Lab. Syllabus.
So, 2 to 3 hours. We can assume that to be the standard. Okay. Good. So, this object-oriented program is actually your semester 3 and 4 sort of.
Yes.
Because you had a yearly pattern.
Yes.
So, clearly the first course is effectively C programming. But does it not harm people to suddenly recall their earlier C programming and start thinking about arrays in the second semester after a large break?
Yeah, it should be like
and
that.
What if a student fails in the first semester but passes in the second semester? How
that
would
do happen, sir.
That happens.
That happens.
So, this is a rather peculiar situation. I would submit that you might want the university to consider the following. Compress that syllabus. Reduce one course from first semester if necessary. So I think what you have done probably is that earlier if you had 10 courses, you have maintained all 10 part 1, part 2. It may be better to regroup them at 5 courses here and 5 courses there. That is the correct interpretation of semester system actually. In fact, one autonomous university in Mumbai has a trimester system. And their course space is killing. Because they have to finish everything in literally 3 months' time.
Second anyway. Year onwards, it is same, but for first year, they have considered
this separate.
The entire course into 2 parts.
So this is the syllabus that is available on the network. I would like to point out we have 2 subjects in third semester related to programming. This is programming methodology These are the contents of the syllabi, textbooks, list of programs. They are clearly mentioned here, you can see. These are the list of programs. And it is available. And then we have the OOT subject in the same semester, fifth subject, object oriented programming. This is the subject. And then again, list of practical is clearly defined. He just took those ideas and wrote it as a list, but otherwise the university have clearly prescribed it. There is no ambiguity as such. Then we have a particular teacher is having freedom to select a theme and define some different tasks. Thank you, sir.